it's Ariana, your tarot life coach, bringing you your June tarot scopes. How you doing, big baby? Thank you so much. Big love, lots and lots of hugs, high fives, and shoulder rubs. I hope you guys are being blessed and that all is working out in your favor. Also, I hope you've checked out. If you've bought a read, just know that you're already registered to win a free read. And the way that I am doing these is I'm going to go through my PayPal account from the first day I started business last year. And everyone who has ordered, if you've ordered more than one, your name will be entered as over and over again, as many as you've bought. And then I will use a random, it's like a random way to pull a number. You put this number in this generator, and then it'll give you the number. And whoever name matches up with that number is going to be the winner. And there are three opportunities to win three reads. Check out the mini commercial, and it will explain more details. So with that being said, welcome back, family. I hope you guys are doing super fantabulous. And if you're new to my channel, welcome. And hopefully you will like, share, or subscribe. Leave us a comment. Let us know what you think. So let's talk about what's going on for the month of June before we jump into your read. And just a little sidebar, guys. I am no astrologist. But on June 9th, the full moon will be 18 degrees Sagittarius. And this is going to be a turning point in relationships and money. It's referred to as the strawberry moon, the full rose moon, or the full honeymoon. All right. And then on June 15th, we have Saturn in opposition, where it's going to be the closest to Earth. And you're going to actually be able to see it. All right. And on June 20th, it's the summer solstice, first day of summer, big baby, and the longest day of the year. This is the progress of the sun throughout the year, which is equal to the process of obtaining enlightenment for us. And on June 23rd, we will have a new moon in Cancer, which is going to have extremely powerful and very fortunate for us. All right, guys, I'm also debuting some new cards. We're working with the seeds of Shakti. Her information will be in the description box, as well as the description of all the other cards. However, are we ready, baby? We're ready to see what June's got for us, because you got this tiger looking at you like, I wish you would say something crazy to me. Now, tiger energy is a very strong energy, Libra. This is raw feelings and emotions, unpredictability, but extremely confident. And this is where you have to understand that you have to trust your intuition to the T. Willpower, personal strength, and courage. And it's also working with the shadow side of yourself. This is physical strength, being confident, sensual, and passionate, a lot of beauty, master of your domain. It's all about your space, being fearless, speaking from your heart, finding the courage. I think that's like the third time I've said courage. This is usually a spirit guide for healers, but a lot of times when he's coming to show you just your medicine, so like if this was your totem, you're usually a healer. However, he's offering his medicine to you this month. This is for protection and guidance. It's all about protecting your space and making sure that the people that are in your space belong there. This is also have a lot of sexual energy. This tells you to avoid selfish agendas and to have night vision to be able to see through the darkness, all right? Now, the spirit that's walking with you through this month is going to be the Hunter of Honor, which I attribute this to you guys because I think of this as the Justice card. Balance and karma, all right? Now, we all must honor places, people, and things, accepting them for what they are and acknowledging the effect they have upon us in every aspect of living. This is celebrating differences, honoring the world around you, respect and praising and accepting praise. I almost feel like it's like going to be one of those months where you're gonna have to keep some people at bay because you kind of got to get a real good feel about somebody this month. That's the vibe I'm getting for you. Just by the way the tiger's looking and you see the Hunter of Honor extending his hand, it's not like he's trying to give you a warm embrace. He's just like, eh, all right, how you doing? Let me see if it's really going to be what it's going to be. Now, the way you're going to work with this energy is talking stick. Talking stick is all about expressing yourself, getting your point of view out there, accepting other people's point of view, because in Native American cultures, this is where you pass the stick. And so as you pass the stick, you have to listen to the other person talking, but at the same time, they have to listen to you. So this is mutual respect and honor when someone is talking. Some of y'all might be going to court. I don't know why that just jumped into my head. Now, shape-shifting is coming through. Now, I love to point out in this card, you see right here that deer, those antlers in the back? Yeah, that's for your protection. You see the full moon? Mm-hmm. lots of illumination going on. And although you're shape-shifting, you're in the darkness, you're in the background, you can still fully see what the heck is going on. Now, this card shows you because it wants you to know that your past is not going to equate your future. Simply shifting your point of view or your belief system can bring an entirely new destiny into being. You can be anything you desire, Libra. It's all about you. It wants you to let go of attachment to your ego and attachment to your identity or whatever the world has put on you. It is time for you to step into your own, which leads us right there into Buddha, all right? Now, Buddha, if you look right here, he's in a meditative state, all right? And the color behind it is blue, and I have a lot of blue here, and then I'm gonna have the talking stick here, and I just have a feeling that this might be the month that you work with your throat chakra. This might be that month that you're speaking from your heart, even those things that might be a little bit uncomfortable, all right? So the exact details of Buddha's life are not known, but his teachings have survived through oral tradition and were recorded approximately 400 years after his death. The teachings of Buddha are deep and sacred and a necessity for spiritual growth. The point of this card is to be aware of attachments, to be compassionate to others, and be mindful of the energy that you release into the universe. Awareness is the key for spiritual awakening and enlightenment. What I'm picking up is you're going to have to, whatever you put out this month, Libra, it's going to be one of those months, it's a catch-22. It's going to come right back to you. So it's going to be very important that you do not become attached to the things that they really aren't for you. It's going to be one of those months when you start speaking the truth and speaking exactly from your heart, all right? Now, see what the Babylonian Tarot has for you. We will be using a 5-card spread. This is a general reading, okay? General reading for Libra, Sun, Moon, or Rising, all right? Now, I did not pre-shuffle your cards, so let's cut the deck and see what we got going on this month. We have, holy moly, it's going to be one of those months. I have 2 spirit guides for you. One that is like being totally heard. He's the action Jackson of the deck, all that fire energy. But this Libra, this energy right here, this communication isn't coming through for you. It's the Carib of Arrows. And this is the one I attribute to air signs. Let's bless this deck. Thanks to Till bless this deck for Libras for the month of June. Show us the energy that's coming in for them, how to work with it, and what advice you have for them. Give us clear and concise messages as we move through and offer healing and insight. Sorry guys, I normally pre-shuffle and I just got carried away. I got started. Let's see, is that it? No. Guys, that's the 3rd time I've rolled a 5 for you. So, I'm going to tell you, some of y'all are clearing out some energy, or some of y'all need to start considering how to clear out that energy in your throat chakra. Speak your truth, baby. Speak your truth. That's the 4th 5. Lord Jesus. What's going on, Libra? And your cards don't really want to shuffle either. There must be some stuff going on with you guys. There we go. Okay. In the 1st position we have, oh, there he is, the Carib of Wands. 2nd position, the Ace of Arrows. 3rd position, there's that Prince of Wands. 4th, the Sun reverse. Some of y'all are dealing with fire sign, possibly a Leo. 5th, the Fool reverse. Overall energy, the 9 of Wands. Yes, I am picking up a lot of action, or we are dealing definitely with a fire sign. As I pull from the bottom of the deck, I'm just going to show you real quick. I have the 6 of Wands. Then I have the Leo card. And then I have the Empress. I'm going to tell you, some of y'all have some stuff going on with a fire sign. Okie dokie. And you got the Tiger. Man, you're all about the big cats, ain't you, baby? So in our 1st position, we have the Carib of Wands. The Carib of Wands for me brings in how to move forward. In the past, you decided to do something. The 2 cards that fell out for what you decided to do was you listened to the Ancestor of Illusion. The Ancestor of Illusion right here, I'm gonna pull it back a little bit. This is the Gazelle Totem, and the Gazelle Totem is all about speaking your truth, opening up your throat chakra, seeing things for what they are, realizing that there might be somebody around you who's truly an enemy and not taking things for face value. at that point, you also have the Dancer of Reconciliation, where you either forgave them or you forgave yourself to move on, all right? And this was like a spiritual message that came to you. Now, in the present, you're not having the breakthrough you thought you would have, all right? Honestly, it's not a bad thing when the Ace is reversed, but it's almost like you thought it was gonna be different. You thought everything was gonna change. There was gonna be a lot of illumination. Communication was gonna pick up. It was like that, bam. But it's kind of like stagnant energy right now. The hidden influence that we have working right now is this Prince of Wands. I wanna get you closer. Okay, there we go. The Prince of Wands, for me, this is Gira. And Gira has this firewall around him. And it's almost like he's like, he wants you to be close because he has a lot of fire and passion and all this desire. But then at the same time, he's like, he doesn't want you too close, okay? Now, this fire sign could possibly be a Leo. The advice I'm gonna tell you is to kind of slow things down. If you're in this relationship, if you reconcile this relationship, there's something that doesn't feel right. And you have to trust that because the sun is reversed here. For me, the sun being reversed is almost like it's a really good thing right now, but we need to get more information before we go and run off the cliff. The reason why I say we run off the cliff is because we have the Fool reversed. The Fool reversed in my deck, and it's like making really bad financial decisions, not really thinking things through. Because this is Enkidu, and Enkidu was created to rescue the people, right? Because Gilgamesh was running amok. And so they send this prostitute to go and drug him because he was a wild man. He lived in the woods. He was doing all the wild stuff, all right? And he couldn't decide, do I stay wild with the animal kingdom or do I go and be human? And so he had to make this really tough decision. And right now, since he's reversed, I feel like, no, you shouldn't make this decision right now, whatever it is, because it's the Fool reverse right by the sun reverse, and those are two major cards. I'm also going to tell you, this is like the third animal with antlers. So I have the gazelle over here, I have a gazelle over here, and we had the elk in the background. Now, for me, antlers are a sign of protection. And the tiger was telling you to protect your domain. I feel like there's something that you really need to protect, whether it's yourself or your family. And the fact that whoever's trying to rush in and save the day is what I think it is, has some ulterior motives, or they're not gonna have that follow through like you thought they were. And I don't know why I'm saying this, but it's almost like they promised you the sun, the moon, and the stars, and they're just gonna give you a happy meal. Like, oh, I'm sorry, I can't give you everything you wanted, Libra. I'm gonna just do this for now. Let me just put a Band-Aid on your broken arm. That'll show that I care, keep you around for a while, but I'm gonna go do some other stuff. Because the overall energy is this Nine of Wands, and this is where Gilgamesh, he wins the battle, but it's reversed, so it's almost like you're going to fight a really hard battle, and you've probably been going through this for a while with somebody. You know, I said court, and I don't know why I said court, but some of y'all are going to be going through like this court for your children, and it's going to take a while. You're going to have to find strength and courage in order to push through and get out of your own head, all right? So that's what I'm getting for you this month, but I do want to clarify some stuff. However, since I have the Six of Wands on the bottom going into the Empress with the Strength card, I'm going to tell you some of y'all have some family things going on, and that's been coming up for some other signs too. Show me what in the past caused this reconciliation and the Dancer, and the Ancestor of Illusion. The Princess of Cups. Okay, now she's upright, so I ain't gonna talk too much trash about her. But however, this person could have either brought you the information, this is a water sign, or this is the child. And so you reconciled because of a child, and now you're feeling like, maybe I was duped. Maybe they had me tricked, all right? Or you're dealing with a female, or it's generally, or male, who's kind of pulled the wool over your eyes, all right? Let's see why this Ace is real. I'm reversed. Show me the energy behind the Ace of Arrows. The Eight of Wands. Okay, so right now there is like no communication, no travel, no discussion. It's at a standstill, like I had said. It's like you really thought that when you reconcile, things were going to be going super copacetic. But unfortunately, you hit a snag in the road. You got somebody who's got their firewalls up. They're not doing what they said they were going to do. And you feel like you've made a mistake. The thing is, I don't know if it's so much a mistake, but it's going to take some time to play out. What does the Prince of Wands have for Libra? You'll have a lot going on this month. The cards are so hard to shuffle. The Eight of Wands reversed. Okay, so this Prince of Wands is helping you see that things ain't what they are supposed to be. So the Eight of Arrows reversed is like, if you're in a relationship, it is a karmic relationship, and the Eight of Arrows is telling you, this is kind of like one that's going to teach you a lesson. It's not the one that you're going to be sticking in for a while. Two eights right next to each other, there's a lot of anxiety going on this month. Sun reversed, I'm going to tell you to watch your health, watch your blood pressure, watch being out in the sun. Watch your stress levels, all right? You need to live. You need to, what is that? Live, laugh, and love. You need to do all of that stuff for yourself, because when this kind of energy, it's almost like you're going to feel like it's going nowhere. But it is moving. It's just at a standstill because you need to make a decision whether you're going to go or you're going to stay. And I think you're going to be there for a while trying to make that decision. And for some of you guys, I'm going to tell you, it is a very, very clear no. And it's for the ones who has been fooled before. This is a promise they made to you months ago, possibly even 9 months ago, because you took them back right after you had a baby or right after you found out something about your kids. Y'all reconciled. And then it just went to boo-boo. All right. Now, I want to see what's going on with this fool. I'm sorry I'm taking so long with your read, guys. I just kind of want to get more information. What's going on with the Fool? And this is a general read, so just know that this isn't, this may not connect with everybody. Yeah, you reconciled. Okay, however, the Two of Arrows, I'm going to tell you, the Two of Arrows in my deck is like when the kings would go in and they'd conquer the land, right? And they made an agreement. And as long as you agreed to everything that man said, you weren't going to die. But if you didn't agree, you see this soldier back here? Mm-hmm. Ready to cut your head off. So, I'm going to tell you, this situation is what you got yourself into. You thought everything was going to be super awesome. You guys reconciled, but only if you play by this person's rules will they play by yours. That is why you have to keep yourself very honorable. You're going to have to play by the rules, baby. Shapeshift into what you need, speak your piece, but also learn the art of detachment. Being close without having to be too damn close. Protect your space with the tiger energy and keep those antlers up this month. You're going to have to protect yourself. And I'm not trying to scare you, Libra. It's not like I think you need to go get a gun and keep it in the house. What I'm picking up is like this is somebody who's promised you too many things that they're not going to be able to complete. All right? That's what I'm getting for you this month. So hopefully we connect, and if we don't, this is another way we could connect. The overall energy coming in for you this month is a gelling. And I want to get you, oh, it's pretty close. Okay, so this is about transition, okay? And this is attributed to the Hangman. This is attributed to Odin. So I'm telling you, that full reverse with the Hangman on this card, you don't have all the information you need in order to move forward. And it says, in the past, what has caused you to be afraid in the past? Acknowledge the fears that are no longer welcome on your path you walk and make a list of your fears. How realistic are they? Have they served any purpose, for example, allowing you to stay within familiar and comforting patterns or behaviors? Make the sacrifices that are necessary in order to remove the unwanted companions from your life. That's that ancestor of illusion. He's not the knight in shining armor that he says he is. Sometimes a Prince of Wands comes out as a knight in shining armor, but you're going to see straight through that boo-boo, and you're going to know exactly what's going on, all right? Now, in the present, It talks about the stone hedges that are there. These stones represent the wisdom of the old ways and the secret of ancient divination still used today. In your life, do you need to change from one thinking to another? Is there something in your life that you're afraid of bringing into the open? Talking stick. Have you agreed to something that is not your truth to protect yourself? Talking stick. Two of Arrows right here. This is the time of transition or of seeing, Eight of Arrows reversed, the world from a new perspective. Your blinders are going to be removed, and that's why you get to the Nine of Wands and you're like, no, bro, we can't go any further. Now, in the future, it says, or your potential is, are your beliefs, or were they, are they your actual beliefs, or were they handed down to you by your parents? From their parents. How strong are your roots? So that's that art of detachment. Just because you were raised a certain way to believe a certain thing and do a certain, I don't know, live a certain way, it does not mean that that's going to resound with you. For example, I'm not trying to be a religious fanatic or anything. I grew up in church every Sunday, Wednesday, Thursday, vacation Bible school, taught Sunday school, everything you can imagine. Loved going to church, went there my entire life, was raised Southern Baptist. Yes, that's right. And at 15, I had something happen at church that we were asked to go. Like, my dad used to preach and stuff. And religion can get pretty ugly, so we left the church for a while, and I could never find a church where I felt like I belonged. Through college, I would go to different churches and visit, and I thought I would find it, and I didn't find it. I went to a couple churches here in Houston as I got older, and I realized a lot of things, and I think this goes right back to that Buddha mentality, is the church is within me, and I have to develop myself spiritually. And almost like you have to kind of look at your belief system, whether it's about marriage. If you believe that there's no such thing as divorce, or if you believe that you have to stay married for the children, who brought you that belief, and why do you believe that? It's almost like you need to sit down and look at it and ask yourself, where did this come from, and why do I believe this? And it's just a matter of time before you realize, maybe there is another way. Maybe there's another aspect. Am I holding back on how I really feel, or am I going to move forward with what I really want? And that's what gelling is trying to tell you. It's just like to kind of look at this situation that's bringing out a lot of anxiety with you. I'm going to tell you, this is going to be a month of high stress. And confidence is going to be hit pretty hard because of all that yellow that's bursting through the cards. This is an emotional situation, possibly with children. If you don't have children, this is a really serious relationship where you felt that this person was going to be super good to you, your knight in shining armor, and they're riding off into the sunset, and you're like, wait a minute, I didn't sign up for this. All right, so that's what I'm picking up for you, Libra. Big, big love, lots and lots of hugs, high fives and shoulder rubs, guys. Thank you for sticking with me for this whole year. If you're interested in a private or personal read, please feel free to hit me up at arianaluciano@gmail.com or on the gram at arianaluciano. All right, fam, be blessed.